Roz, just because the last time you went to Mexico you were hit on more than a piñata doesn't mean that was the purpose of my visit as well.
What the hell was that?
Oh, shoot, he's not even here.
Who?
Do you remember that guy who dumped me last month? I just wanted him to see me with another guy so he'd know how completely over him I am.
Good idea, Roz. That doesn't work. Why don't we get married and have some children? That'll really fix his wagon.
One minute we're hot and heavy, and then he just stops calling. It's so humiliating when someone treats you like you don't even exist.
How can someone not hear the difference between Frasier and Frasier? What kind of explanation can there possibly be for this level of unprofessionalism?
I think I'm pregnant.
What, Roz? How?
I don't know how. No one is more careful than I am when it comes to birth control. Even the best protection is only effective 99 out of 100 times. I can't beat those odds.
In fact, we don't even know for sure if there is a baby.
We do now.
Is it that you don't know who the father is?
Of course I know.
Well, then why don't you tell me?
Because I haven't even told him yet.
Oh.
And I'm not sure I'm going to tell him.
He's a nice kid, Rick.
Yes, he is.
Working here to put himself through school?
Yes, he is.
He's the father, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Everything in my life is about to change. My body, my love life.
I'm sure you're schooled in the international language.
Oh, yes, Ross, say something amusing in Esperanto.
Until then.
Okay, you're right. We're on the voyage of the damned. Last night was a disaster.
Oh, right, your date. You didn't tell him you were pregnant before the date?
So, I tell him. 5 minutes later, he tells me his pager is vibrating. He has an emergency. He has to go to work.
Well, maybe he was telling the truth.
He sells wicker furniture. Look who you're talking to. I've been down this road so many times, I call it the Roz Expressway.
I've heard that phrase before, but in a slightly different context.
Well, Ross, maybe it's time to set some limits. Good Lord, how hard can it be to say no just once? Oh, well, look who I'm talking to.
Every time I see something cute in the window, I remember how I look, and I think, no way. Mm-hmm. Here we go again.
Well, he's half Greek. He gets his looks from his mom.
I bet he gets looks from lots of women.
Ross. Roz Doyle, my producer. This is Dr. Clint Weber, the new host of Health Watch.
Hi, great to meet you.
So, you're new?
That's right.
And a doctor?
That's right.
You remember Roz Doyle, of course.
Yes, hello.
Who could forget that infectious laugh?
So, mind if I join you?
Well, actually,
we were hoping you would. Mine was this lifeguard. He had long blonde hair and the bluest eyes. He used to get so sunburnt, I'd spend hours just peeling the skin off his back. But I figured I'd better get out and do a little flirting before I forget how.
Can I offer you something?
Oh, yeah.
My God, Roz, you are rusty.
You people are always so superficial.
Yeah, seems like everybody nowadays is all about appearances.
Mm-hmm.
Well, should we get a drink?
Yeah, sure. I'm not really very thirsty.
Me either.
Okay.
See ya.
My God, Mark Twain gave a reading there.
Oh, yeah, I know that place. He used to have a boyfriend who liked to make out in the occult section.